Well, it's a hard life being a smart doll. Come on, Mariah, we need to get this done. As you can see today, I'm going to be looking at these little masks here, which I think, shall we leave her asleep? No, we won't, because I do need to take it off to show you. So come on, we need this off. All I've done is tied it at the back with a little bow, nothing too tight. There you are. My wall seems to be very comfy, so I will leave her sat on the wall and we will pop her just slightly out of the way. Oh, she's come off the wall. There you go, you can stay there. So as I was saying, we're making this little sleep mask. It's nice and simple to make. I have done it in two sides, so I've already got one side done. You can do it with just one, but I thought it made it a little bit more sturdy. And also, if you're wanting to embroider any detail or stitch anything on, you stitch it on first before you crochet them together, so it just makes it a little bit neater, and the ribbon's just threaded through afterwards. So I'm using I'm using a 4-ply cotton. This is a patent 100% cotton, one of my favorite cottons here in the UK to use. I'm using a 3mm hook, and as I've just mentioned, it is UK terms we're referring to, so we might as well just get going because it's not really that difficult. I've got a little bit of ribbon there, a little bit for embroidery, my scissors, my needles, all the bits that I usually have, and it's going to be working in rows, which is unusual for me. I do have a tendency to work sort of spiral, I mean amigurumi style, more than anything else, but this I think needed to be worked in rows. So off we go. Slip knot. As I say, I've already got one side done, so it'll make it a little bit quicker. You don't have to watch me do both sides. Onto the hook, not too tight. You can do this in other 4-ply yarn. I did try it in a 4-ply acrylic. I didn't like the effect that it got. I preferred, I think the cotton makes it harder, more of a solid effect. So I preferred that. That's why I did that. So here we are. We have our slip knot. We're going to do 3 chain. 1, 2, and 3. We're going to do another chain, but that's going to be the chain for turning chain. Now that's the turning chain, so in the we've got the 1, 2, and 3. Into that number 3 we're going to do 2 double crochets because I want an increase. Into the next one it's just 1 double crochet, and into the next one it's 2 double crochets. So we've increased 1 at each side, so we now have 5 stitches, not 3. Just tighten that up a little bit, just there we go. So chain, there's going to be a chain and then turn on every row. I keep wanting to say round. Right, into the first one, which is directly below that chain, it's there. I'm going to do 2 double crochets in 1, so that's another increase. Then I'm going to do a 1 double crochet in the next one, 1 double crochet in the next one, and 1 double crochet in the next one. That leaves us 1 stitch. A little bit hard to get into this one because we do need to make sure we pick it up well. So you need to make sure you pick up both pieces, and you're going to do 2 double crochets. So we've increased at each end. So it was 2 in 1, 2 double crochets in 1 there, then a 1, 1 and a 1, and then 2 double crochets in that end one. We now have 7 stitches. That's the most we're going to have on here. So I'm going to do a chain and turn my work. I'm going to work directly below where that chain is. So this is a stitch here. Don't jump across, otherwise you'll be decreasing. We need to go in there and we're going to do 7 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and number 7. Make sure you pick up both bits. Like I said, after an increase it's always a bit difficult to get in there. And there we go, that's our 7. So that is 1 row of 7. We need 4 of those, so this is our second row. So I've chained, then I've turned. You can turn then chain, up to you. I just find it easier that way. So 7 stitches. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Okay, so that was 2 rows. Another one, so chain, then turn, and 7 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Make sure I nearly picked up just 1 bit, 2 bits, 7. Right, again, I'll just mention this turn. A lot of patterns will say turn your work then do a chain. I just prefer to preempt that chain and do it now and then I find it easier to turn. Entirely up to you, that is. And again, watch where you're going, because you're tempted, because of that chain, you think, well, that's a stitch, and you're tempted to go in there. That chain in this particular situation, a pattern should usually tell you, does not count as your first stitch. It's just a turning chain, that is all it is. So the stitch needs to be directly below it. Because let's say if you don't, you're going to decrease where you don't want to decrease. So this is our last of our four rows, seven stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Now we need to get a little bit of shaping in here now. So one end you're going to be decreasing, the other end you're not. So this is our first decrease. So I'm going to do that chain again first, then turn my work. Now I want to decrease by doing these two, the first two double crochets together. So I go in, pull it through, I don't finish the stitch. Into the next one, pull it through. We should have three on the hook. We pull it through all three. That is a decrease. We're then just going to do one double crochet in each of the rest. So we should have 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Chain and turn our work. Now remember, it's only this end that we're decreasing. So this one is a normal double crochet and then a normal double crochet. So that's 2, 3, 4, because we want these last two. So I've only gone up to the last two. Then do these two together. Ta-da! And chain and turn. We've got one last decrease at this particular point. So remember, that's the first stitch. So this stitch and this stitch are going to be together. So partial, partial, pull through all three, and then just double crochet to the end. Now we're going to just do one row of double crochet. So chain and turn. We should have four stitches. We should have 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, we're now going to start increasing because we need to come back round this curve. So chain before we turn. So in the first one, which is directly below the chain, it's going to have two double crochets. That's our first increase, and then just one double crochet in the rest of them. So we've now got five stitches. Chain and turn. We don't increase at this end. This end stays flat. Can you see the work stays flat there? So we're only increasing at this end. So this is just a double crochet in each to the last one. So one double crochet all the way along until we get to the last stitch. And when we do get to that last stitch, we're going to do two double crochets because we want to increase. So 1 and 2, chain and turn. We need one more increase. So directly below that chain, you're going to do two double crochets in one stitch. And then you're just going to double crochet to the end. That is the last of our increases. We should be back up to seven stitches, hopefully, because obviously you need both sides equal. Well, I'm going to chain and I'm going to turn. And now I need four rows of seven stitches. So off we go. Turn my hook. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, if you haven't got 7 at this point, you've either not increased enough or you've increased wrong somewhere. So you do need to check it. They don't take long to undo, even if you did it wrong. I had to undo that one when I did it. So that was one row of 7. So chain and turn. Our second row of 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. That was row 2. Row 3 next. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. That was row 3, wasn't it? One more row. Now I am counting, and I think you should count when you do this, because if you count and suddenly realize you've not got enough, it means you can rectify the mistake a little bit quicker. Then you get to the end and you go, oh, there's not enough stitches. So always double check what your numbers are there. So let me double check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. I'm okay still. This is my last row of sevens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So again, we're now curving round a bit. It's a tiny weeny bit of decreasing, nothing too big. So we chain and then we turn, but we need to decrease at both ends. Remember, we increased at both ends at the beginning, but we're just reversing that to make sure it's equal. So the first two are going to be two together. So in, we don't finish the stitch, in, we pull it through, we have three, pull it through all three. We're going to do a double crochet in each one up to the last two. Right, so we've got two left and we're going to double crochet those two together. Yep, chain and turn. We're going to do the same again. The first two, you're going to double crochet together. You're then only going to have one stitch. And then the last two, you're going to be double crocheting together. And that's it. You've done your crochet. You need two of these. Well, you don't have to have two of these. You can, because obviously we're going to crochet round, which neatens it when we crochet them together. You could just crochet round that and attach a little ribbon tie or a piece of elastic. There's absolutely no reason for that. It's just I wanted it a little bit more sturdy. Entirely up to you. It's like with the decoration. Up to you what you decide to do. We're going to get rid of these bits because I tried sewing those eyelashes on earlier with these bits. It was getting in the way all the time. So let's get rid of them now. Sew them in on the back. So it's the bit that's going to be sort of in on this one. So it's two wrong sides together, remember, when you do crochet them together. You can sew them together if you don't like to crochet them together, but I do believe that the crochet does make it a lot neater. I mean, they don't look too bad like that, but I feel they need to be neaten off, and by crocheting them together, I think it makes a massive difference. So I'm just getting rid of my ends because I want to do a little bit of sewing. Can't really call it embroidery. Let me get the right side. That's the one I want to get rid of it on. Just a couple of stitches. It's nothing complicated. You can design whatever you want. As I say, you can leave them plain. You can cover them in flowers. I mean, I've stitched a little bow on. However you want to decorate them up, really. And you can decorate them up to the personality of your smart doll as well. Ta-da! Right, so this is the one I'm going to stitch on because that is the one I did earlier. I am using, this is crochet cotton. You can use embroidery cotton by all means. I do find that the crochet cotton holds itself very slightly better. I've got a lot of embroidery cottons and I do use them. And they don't certainly have a place. But I do think, you see I've got a little tail on that knot, and get rid of that. I do think this, I don't know, it just seems to keep it neater. Now to actually do the eyes, first time when I did it, I'm like, oh, I'm not going to get these equal. Take your time and decide. So I know I want it from there to about there. So I'm going to start here, I think. Don't pull it too tight through. And I'm just going to jump down a stitch. I decide whether I'm on the right side. I'm not on the right side. That is why it's more lumpy that side. I can't see my patterning properly. There isn't a massive right or wrong side when you're working in rows. Not compared with when you're doing amigurumi. But you sometimes can just tell very slightly. Let me see the side that looks the smoothest. That's what I want. This side looks a little bit smoother. So I'm going to go in. And all I did one diagonal stitch. Yeah. I'm going to do one stitch along. You don't have to do sleepy eyes. I'm going to do another one along. This one's going to be slightly different to my other one. Count how many stitches I did. I did four. And I'm going to do one that's going to go up. Now I want my eyelashes, so I'm going to take one eyelash that comes out slightly. Yeah, I'm going back in the same hole as where I started the two stitches. and I'm going to bring those down because we're sleepy faced, aren't we? I seem to have got an extra eyelash. Oh, I've got a little less eyelashes than the other one. No, I haven't. Or have I? No, I haven't. It's there, isn't it? There we go. See, I'm not overly happy with that, so I'm actually going to undo it. This is how quick it is to undo, so you don't have to over sort of worry about it. Don't do it too tight to start with, and then you will be able to do it. I just feel there's a big gap between those two eyelashes. And that is because, if I look at my stitches, I need one there, one there, one there, one there, and one there. I think I've just taken that one a little bit too far over. So you will make mistakes, and that's why I'm quite happy to show my mistakes when I do make them, because I think people should not worry quite as much as they do about making them. It's not the end of the world, is it? Just undo it, a little bit of patience. I didn't used to have patience, I have developed patience. That's better. Look, they're more even now. I don't want her eyelashes all over the place. And our very last one. Oop, I'm going to have to move it over a bit. I have a tendency when I'm sewing to bring my work very close to me. And in the last bit. That looks a bit better, doesn't it? I think that's better. That sort of fits nicely. So all I'm doing in the back is a little knot. You don't have to over worry about it because that's going on top of it, remember. So just make sure it's solid. It's not going to go anywhere. And just give it a little snip. Right, we need me. I have to do the other eye, whether I want to or not at this point, because I can't crochet it together until I've done the second eye. So let's have a look. That looks about equal. And the first one's going to go down slightly. And then we've got one across. Still about equal, yeah. One across. And one on an angle. That's a little bit tight, that. Don't pull it too tight because it does sort of pull the work and it doesn't look too good then. That's approximately right. Eyelash time. I've only just got enough thread here. Sorry, I just noticed something on the phone then. It says my daughter sent a video. I don't know what she's sent. It's something that the kids are doing, probably. Eyelash. Where's that hole? It's there. The holes I'm going into are the ones that the other stitches came out of. And our last one. Let me see if I'm happy with that. Little bit crooked. But I'm not going to make you watch me do that again and again. What I'm going to do is crochet together and then I'll undo it after the fact. So, eyelashes are optional. Crochet together time. So, we need to take the two, make sure which side you're happy with, which you want as the other side. It doesn't really matter. Pop them on together. Now, I find they hold relatively well like that, but if you do want to pin them together or clip them together, you can do. So I'm choosing any hole here, and I'm finding its matching partner on the other side. We're going to grab the yarn, and I'm just going to pull it through, and I'm going to do a chain. Then I'm going to go back in that hole and do a double crochet. That anchors it. That's the reason I've done that. And then I'm going to try and match up all the way around. That one's where the knot was, so that's not always so easy. All the way around, making sure I'm not pulling one side more than the other, because it'll pucker. Across the top's usually easier. They line up nicely. Now I am making sure I'm picking up all the way through. Make it nice and solid. I quite like crocheting things together. I think it gives sort of, well, if it's a blanket or something like that, it gives a nice fancy edge. But it just makes it nice and solid. And not everybody likes sewing. A lot of people do just like to crochet. So if you can crochet it together, it's a bonus, really. So it's not taking too long, that. Obviously, you don't have to work at my pace. You can sort of get on with it at your own pace. It, to be honest, I think it's the sort of video that if you just watched it, you'd probably go, oh yeah, I can do that. You can then sort of pick up your work and maybe just come back to it for reference if you need. Be careful there, because that one's gone a little bit wide. Make sure these edges do stay side by side. You can see that's where the knot was again, so you've got to be careful where you go in there. There we go, that's okay. We're almost round. It doesn't take long. I mean, what we got on the video? We got 20 minutes on the video. But remember, I had already made one side. I'd say it would take you 10, 15, maybe 20 minutes to do a side. Then it depends on what detail you want. If you don't want any detail, well, you're straight into crocheting them together. And then we've got, what, another 5-10 minutes crocheting together. If you're not used to crocheting together, it may take a little bit longer. Look, that one's caught. So what I'm going to do, take it out, push it back in, and have another go. And we're okay now. It's a little bit tight for some reason. Right, we're to the middle now. We've just got the one half, well, not even a full half to go around, just the bottom of this other one. I'm hoping this is nice and clear. I've picked a light colour particularly because I know this yarn doesn't stain, but it's going on a face. You don't want to risk any staining. These cottons are really good for that, and I do use some of the darker colours, but I decided because it was going on a face, I just wanted to sort of mention, watch out for staining, because you don't want to, I know you can get some of it off, but you don't want to really have to be messing about with that. Right, that's the last stitch we're at, and I'm going to just pop in that first one and do a slip stitch. Fast enough. And basically we've done. We're just going to get rid of these two ends. We can just thread them between now, because we've got that sort of slight space in between the two pieces, haven't we? So in we go. So thread it through a bit. Then I'm just going to go over to make sure it's going to stop in and thread it through again. One more bit. Then we're going to thread the ribbon. And like I said, I have stitched the bow. You don't have to stitch the bow. You can actually glue it on if you prefer. I like to stitch because I like to make sure my things are going to be staying there. Right, I'm going to go through these a bit because I want this one to make sure it's going to stay. So I've just threaded it through the outer bit. Right, that will do me there. Snip it off. Now, as far as the ribbon's concerned, because we do have that space in between, we can sort of cheat a bit, really. So I'm just threading it through my needle and from the back deciding where I want it to go through. Now, this is, needle isn't really very long, but we just sort of shuffle it up so you know where you want it to come out. We might need to have to pull it a little bit. I think the other needle might have been better. And there we are. So we have our ribbon through, and that's not going to go anywhere. It's nice and flat, and you cut it to whatever length you want. I think the finer ribbon works better. You could put a little bit of elastic on, and then it's sort of, you can just slot it onto the head rather than having to tie it. And so really up to you. And then decoration. I've just got a tiny bow, and I've just popped the little bow on there, so we've got the little mask. And as I say, I've actually stitched it on with some white sewing cotton, that's all. But you could put flowers on. I've got all these bits of embellishments out, and I'm like, what shall I put on? And I ended up going for the simpler because I thought it looked quite sweet, because I'd already done the eyelashes. But I think if I'd done it plain, I had thought about doing a frill of lace round. There's all sorts you can do. It's sort of, your imagination can go wild on it, and obviously the colours. Just watch for any staining. So that was it. That was a nice quick video there. Only 24 minutes. I mean, I can download it straight from my phone. That is brilliant as well. So Mirai here can have her little face mask back, and she can have another kip on my wall, can't you, missus? But thank you very much for watching. Please like, subscribe and share if you did enjoy it, and I hope to see you very soon. Bye.